Hello and welcome. And while leaving the last session, we were talking about 2.16, and in fact, we had discussed this one in the last session, and I also asked you to actually give it a try. I do not know how many among you actually really have attempted this one, but still I will do it for you. I have already discussed the rate that rate of profit on cost is 1/4 and 1/3, and rate of profit on cost is 1/4. Nature Sprite Limited. So goods sent to branch is given to you. Straight away we can begin the proceedings now. And towards the debit side of branch stock account, I will write here goods sent to branch account, correct? So two goods sent to branch account and given to us is 18 lakhs. So I will write here 18 lakhs. And in the branch adjustment account, I will have to write the loading. So I will write here load on goods sent to branch account 18 lakhs. And rate of loading is 1/4, which we have already computed in the last session when I discussed the question. It was 450. Goods returned to branch. Next item, 20,000. Need not require to tell you anything regarding this one. Goods sent to branch returns 20,000. Correct. Now you will take it to the debit side of branch adjustment account. You will simply write here loading. Goods sent to branch returns 20,000 into 1/4. Your loading will be equal to 5,000. Next item which is given to you is stock in the beginning. Now stock in the beginning given to you is 2,40,000. So stock in the beginning, you write in the branch stock account opening stock or opening balance, that is equal to 2,40,000. So you write here 2,40,000. And then you will move to the credit side of branch adjustment account and write loading on opening stock 2,40,000 into 1/4. That is equal to 60,000. Loading amount is 60,000. Then branch debtors in the beginning is given to you 2,15,000. If you are preparing branch debtors account also, then write it over there. Balance brought down 2,15,000. Opening debtors. Then besides that, in this particular question, we have been given cash and credit sales. Cash sales is 580 and credit sales is 11,40,000. Cash sales. $5,80,000. Credit sales. $11,40,000. Credit sales will also find place in the debtors account. And in the debtors account, you will write here credit sales. That is equal to $11,40,000. Correct. Then next one we have got in this case is cash receipt from debtors 10,45,000. Needless to tell you that it will find place in the debtors account only. Cash from debtors 10,45,000. Then we have in this particular case discount and bad debts. Discount is 14,800. Bad debts is 9,200. Discount 14,800. Bad debts 9,200. Discount and bad debts are treated as a sort of loss, so that is the reason. Discount and bad debts will also be put up towards the debit side or branch P&L. Discount is 14,800. Bad debts. Bad debts is 9,200. Then we have in this case sales return. An amount of sales return is 25,000. Sales return will find place first towards the credit side of debtor's account, that is against the credit sales. And because credit sales are also written in the branch stock account, we shall also write it towards the debit side of branch stock account. $25,000, correct? Then we have here salary and wages, rent and rates and sundry expenses. All these items you will write here. Salary and wages. Salary and wages. 180,000. Then we have rent, rates and taxes. Rent, rates and taxes, 42,000. Then you have sundry expenses. Sundry expenses are worth rupees 15,000. You are going to write here 15,000. And then stock, closing stock, 3,60,000 is given to you. So closing stock, you will write over here. 3,60,000. You will take the loading. $3,60,000 × 1/4. That is equal to 90,000. Correct? This is how you are going to do this particular question. I think everything is over. Now all we need to do is to tally this one. And for the same, I will decide which side is, I will not decide, in fact, I will have to look into the question, find out which one is greater. This time credit side is greater. So 35,000 happens to be your surplus. Opening stock is given, goods sent to branch is already there. So third preference is always given to surplus. Surplus will be your 35. Surplus never ever split. So 35,000 you will put it across, that is branch adjustment account. Now you'll find out your gross profit. Gross profit is equal to 4,50,000. Some of you might have done this question of your own. You simply actually match your answers. Gross profit 4,50,000. And then finally you will subtract all these expenses to arrive at your net profit, which happens to be 1,89,000. 1,89,000. Branch debtors account, not much of significance. However, we will get the closing balance carried down. I think it will be equal to 2,61,000. So this is how you are supposed to do this particular question. Not a tough one. Now 2.17, we move over to. Under 2.17, as you can see, actually, you have been given information only related to these 3 months, January, February, and March. For example, goods sent to branch is given to you. That means during these 3 months, total goods sent to branch at cost, because it is purchase price given to you, that is equal to 1,50,000. So total goods sent to branch during these 3 months is equal to 1,50,000 at cost price. Sales as shown by the branch. So total sales is equal to 38 plus 42, 80 plus 55, 1,35,000. So total sales, and all these sales are credit sales. I will let you know why it will be considered as credit sales in this question. Then total cash remitted from debtors and sent back to head office, 20,000 plus 51 plus 35, that is equal to 1,06,000. It means total worth of cash received from debtors. And goods returned is equal to 4,200. So 3 months information is given to us. And his stock at the end of the year is 53,400 at invoice price. Only thing is that goods sent to branch, which is given to you, is at purchase price. Purchase price is nothing but your cost price. So in this case, when you are going to compute the rates, you have been given at 909 limited, which carried on retail business, opened a branch. So it's a newly opened branch, correct? Where all sales are on credit basis. So that's the reason why I told you these are credit sales. And it is given that goods are invoiced at 10% above cost. So goods are invoiced at 10% above cost. Correct? This is the question. So 2.17. 2.17 is the question. And first of all, I will compute the rates for you. Cost price plus margin. Cost price plus margin is equal to your invoice price. Now, rate of profit is given on cost. I will consider cost as 100, margin will be 10, invoice price will be equal to 110. So rate of profit on invoice price will be equal to 10 by 110, or you can simply write 1 by 11. Similarly, rate of profit on cost will be 10 by 100, or you can write 1 by 10. So first item which is given to us is goods sent to branch. I will write it towards the debit side of branch stock account to goods sent to branch account. Now this item is at cost. I will write here at cost. Total goods sent during these 3 months at cost is equal to 1,50,000. So I will write here 1,50,000. Now what I am going to do is I will have to convert it into invoice price. In order to convert it into invoice price, I will have to apply the rate of profit on cost, which happens to be 1 by 10. So 15,000. So that means in the current year, 1,65,000 worth of goods at invoice price must have been sent by head office to the branch. Towards the opposite side, I am going to write here loading. Then I will write loading on goods sent to branch account. I can straight away write 15,000 as loading. But if you want to show, you will have to reflect it this in this manner. Goods sent to branch at invoice price 165. Because you have written the invoice price now, you will have to take the rate of profit on invoice price 1 by 11. So 15,000 will be the amount which you are going to put here. 15,000. This is how you are going to manage this one. Then sales. These are credit sales. First of all, we are supposed to write the credit sales in the branch stock account. I will write here credit sales. All sales are on credit basis. We computed 1,35,000 3 month sales, correct? And then if we are preparing branch debtors account, let us say this is branch debtors account. In the branch debtors account, I will write here credit sales 1,35,000. Then very next item was total cash received. Cash received from branch 20 plus 51 plus 35, which we computed 1,06,000. Again, this item will come towards the credit side of the branch debtors account. So cash received 1,06,000. Correct. And then you in this question, you have returns to head office. Return to head office. In the branch stock account, I will write goods sent to branch account. Returns. Total returns is equal to 4,200. And then I will go over to the debit side of branch adjustment account. Write it over there. Goods sent to branch account. Loading. Loading I have already written. 4,200. In fact, these are returns. 4,200 into 1 by 11. Approximately loading amount will be equal to 482, because otherwise it is 481 point something. So I have appropriated it to 482. And then we have here closing stock 53,400, as you can see. So closing stock, I will put over here closing stock 53,400. Then again, we will have to take the loading of this item also. So I will write here closing stock, loading on closing stock, 53,400 into 1 by 11. लोडिंग विल बी 4855 अप्रोक्सीमेटली अप्रोक्सीमेटली बिकॉज इन पॉइंट्स अदरवाइज इट इज कमिंग हियर. नथिंग एल्स इज गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन. इट्स ए स्मॉल क्वेश्चन. सो नाउ वी कैन क्लोज इट डाउन एंड दिस टाइम यू आर हैविंग ए सरप्लस. Logically, if you have a balancing figure towards the debit side in the branch stock account, you should consider first as a first preference opening stock. But in this, even though in this question opening stock is not given, but I cannot consider it as opening stock simply because it's a newly opened branch. So second preference goods sent to branch, which is given. So third preference surplus 27,000. Surplus without splitting, you will take in full to the credit side of branch adjustment account right over there, 27,000. 27,000, correct? And then you will write here gross profit. And in fact, in this question, whatever gross profit you are going to get, that itself will be your net profit also, simply because in this question, as you can see, there is no item related to net profit. So whatever gross profit you have, that itself will be your net profit also. And then finally, you will prepare your branch debtors, close your branch debtors account. And from that particular account, what you will get? Closing balance 29,000. So it's a small question, simple question, correct? So you can manage this question, no problem. 2.18 is the next one. In the 2.18, it says that Classic Limited has a branch at City X and goods are sent by the head office to the branch at selling price, which is cost plus 25%. So question states, Classic Limited has a branch at City X and goods are sent to the branch at selling price, which is cost plus 25%. So I need not require to talk about the rate. Rate of profit on cost, cost plus margin is equal to invoice price. Now I have tired of actually telling of all these things so many times. Cost 100, because rate is based on cost. Margin 25, invoice price 125. So rate of profit on cost will be 25/100 and on invoice price it will be equal to 1/5. Opening debtors is given to you. You will write in the opening debtors. Closing debtors is given. So both these items you are going to write in the debtors. Similarly, inventories, opening and closing stock, you are going to put in your branch stock account. Cash sales during the year is given to you. Now this is the line which is important, because here in bold, please pay attention, it is written that all the cash collected from customer and cash sales, all the cash collected from customers and cash sales is deposited in the head office. We are very well aware that branch actually receives or collects cash from two sources. One is cash sales and another is from customer, cash from debtors or customers. These are the two vital sources for branch to collect the cash, which ultimately is sent back by the what we call branch to the head office, isn't it or not? So in this question, cash sales and cash from debtors is given to you. So question in the bold actually states that all the cash collected from the customer and from the cash sales is deposited in the head office account. Now, here in this question, you have been given cash sales during the year 60,000. Now, cash sales is 60,000. And then it is given that total amount deposited in the head office account during the year is 1,29,000. So, total amount deposited in the head office account is 1,27,000. And we know that total amount deposited in the head office account comprises of two things. One is cash sales and another from cash from debtor. Now, if I would say that I have deposited total 1,27,000 in the head office account, out of that cash sales is 60, it automatically would lead me to the fact that cash from debtors must be equal to 67,000. So in this question, you have extracted this figure, cash from debtors 67,000. And now you need not require to do anything because you will have to incorporate cash sales and cash from data. Indirectly, it means this item will automatically get incorporated. Return of goods to head office is 5,000, fine. And then we have salary paid, rent paid, and discount to customer, bad debt. Spoilage is given in the question. Spoilage means deficiency or what we call your shortage. So in this question, it is already given to you, correct? Actually, there is nothing for me to actually solve, but still I will do it for you. So this is your branch stock account. Branch adjustment account. Then we will prepare branch P&L account. And in this question, branch debtors will play important role. Why branch debtors will play important role? Because so far under section 2, we have seen that branch debtor account is almost like a silent spectator, isn't it? Having not much of what we call vibrancy. However, now we will see to it that in this particular question, it has a role to play. Why I'm saying so, I will let you know in a short while, but just pay attention. Branch debtors. Question looks very simple, innocuous, no doubt about that, but you will have to still exercise caution. 2.18 is the one which we are picking up now. Opening debtors. So question starts with debtors itself. That is quite unusual, but still we'll do it in the debtors account. I will write opening balance as 12,000. So I will write here opening balance 12,000. Then we have been given closing balance also. So I will write in the debtors account closing balance 14,000. So 14,000 I have written now. Correct? Then we have been given balances of inventories. So in the branch stock account, I will write opening balance or opening inventory or opening stock, whatever you may like to write. 16,000 is your opening stock. And your closing stock is 17,000. So immediately you will have to take the loading part. In the branch adjustment account towards the debit side, you will write to load on closing stock. As far as closing stock is concerned, 17,000 is the amount, loading 1 by 5. I think that will be equal to 3,400. Just let me check it up. 17,000 divided by 5. 3,400. Yes, it is. 3,400. Similarly, we will take the loading of opening stock, load on opening stock. Opening stock is your 16,000 at invoice price. Rate of loading on invoice price 1 by 5, 3,200. Now, next item is cash sales during the year. So, cash sales during the year, obviously, you are going to write here cash sales. Cash sales is 60,000. And after the cash sales, as you can see, we have been given total amount deposited. We are not going to write this amount anywhere. However, we use this figure to find out cash receipt from debtors. Cash receipt from debtor was 67,000. So in the debtors account, I am going to write cash from debtors. Cash from debtors. How did you find it out? Your total amount deposited was 1,27,000. Out of that, 60,000 was your cash sales. So remaining amount must be cash from debtors, that is 67,000. Correct? Cash from debtors under this method comes only in the debtors account. And now we have got returns of goods to head office, that is equal to 5,000. So I will write here goods sent to branch account. returns amount is 5,000. We will take the loading, load on goods sent to branch, returns 5,000 into 1 by 5, that is equal to 1,000. Then we have got salaries paid. So salaries and rent, amount of salaries is equal to 6,000. You will write here salaries 6,000. Salaries paid 6,000. Rent paid is equal to 4,000. Then discount to customer, I will write it in the debtors account also, but it also finds place in the P&L. So we will write it here also. Discount 2,000. And then we have bad debts. Amount of bad debts is equal to 1,000. First, let me write it in the debtors account. So in the debtors account, I will write here discount 2,000. Discount is equal to 2,000. Then I will also write bad debts. Amount of bad debts is 1,000. And the last item, which is spoilage, and this time in the question, spoilage is given to you, so you are going to write spoilage. Spoilage means deficiency or shortage. So spoilage is given in the question 2,000. Loading of spoilage will be written in the branch adjustment account. Spoilage, loading on spoilage 2,000 into 1 by 5, that is 400, correct? And then you write spoilage at cost price. So spoilage at cost is spoilage at cost 2,000 minus 400, that is equal to 1,600. Is it clear to you or not? So this is how you are going to do this one, and nothing else in this question. But I told you in this question, you cannot straight away tell your branch stock account. Reason being is that in this question, you are not having the amount of credit sales. So that was the reason actually why I was telling that in this question, branch debtors account will play a significant role because amount of credit sales is not given. That means under this system, if credit sales are not given, then branch debtors account must be tallied first. So by tallying the branch debtors account, you will get credit sales, that is 72,000. This is your balancing figure. Now you will take the credit sales figure, 72,000. Now you will write it over here. It's an interesting question. Now you will tally this account. If you will tally this account, I will tell you the figure. What will be your balancing figure? Balancing figure will be 1,40,000. What should I treat it? First preference is given to opening stock, which is given in the question. Second preference is always given to goods sent to branch. And in this question, goods sent to branch account is not given. So that is why you will consider this one as your balancing figure. Is it clear to you or not? So goods sent to branch is your balancing figure. You will take the loading of goods sent to branch in the branch stock branch adjustment account. Goods sent to branch 1,40,000 into 1 by 5. I think it will be equal to 28,000. Yes, it is. Now you will tally your branch stock account. Branch adjustment account, sorry. From there, you are going to get your gross profit. Now, rest of the things are mere formality, which you can do it of your own. 26,400. 26,400. Now, write your gross profit. 26,400. And finally, get your net profit, 11,800. 11,800 will be your net profit. Correct? This is how you have to do this one. After having done this one, next one is following are the transaction related to Kohima branch of the head office for the year ended 31st of March 2022, and you are required to furnish proper accounts under stock and data system. And below he has written, below it is written that goods are invoiced at cost plus 25%. So rate of profit on cost 1 by 4, on invoice price it will be 1 by 5. Opening stock, you will write here in the stock account as opening balance. You will take the loading of opening stock. Loading of opening stock will be equal to, just wait. Right. So, what will be your loading? Opening stock 20,000, your loading will be equal to, if you want to show, you can show it this in this manner, 20,000 into 1 by 5, that is equal to 4,000, correct? Debtors are given, you can write the figure in the debtors account as opening balance 9,000. Goods sent to branch, first of all, you are going to write in the branch stock account. Goods sent to branch is equal to 1,10,000, and actually it is 1,10,000. It is 1,10,000. Please pay attention. It is written as 11,000. Actually, this figure is 1,10,000. Correct? 1,10,000. And then you will take the loading of this item in the branch adjustment account. You will write 1,10,000 into 1 by 5. That is equal to 22,000. Next item is cash and credit sales, needless to add where these items are going to be written. Towards the credit side of branch stock account, you will write cash sales, credit sales. In the debtors account, then you will write credit sales. This is your debtors account, opening balance 9,000 and credit sales 60,000 you are going to write over here. Then you have been given in this particular question, cash remitted to branch for expenses. Cash remitted to branch for expenses. Actually, you need not require to prepare branch account, but just any expense account, but just to make you understand, cash sent to branch for expenses. Suppose if I prepare expense account, just to make you understand. Now, head office is sending cash for expenses. So, head office has sent to branch 8,000 worth of cash for expenses. So if I'm going to balance this account, I will write towards the opposite side. It means all this cash which was sent must have been spent by branch in meeting the expenses. In the P&L account, you will write to expenses. In simple words, in the P&L account, you are going to write expenses as I have written. You can see branch expenses account 8,000, correct? Similarly, cash collected from debtors is now given to you as 57,000. Cash collected from debtors, you will write in the debtors account, cash from debtors, that is 57,000. Then in this question, you have been given discount allowed to debtors, that is 1,500. In the debtors account, you will write towards the credit side. And in the P&L account, don't forget to write, correct? Then you have been given a stock at the end of the year 38. So you are going to write here 38,000. You will take the loading of 38,000. So loading on closing stock, that is 38,000 into 1 by 5. 7,600. Then you are going to tally your this particular account. You will get balancing figure as what we call shortage, also known as deficiency and spoilage. You will take the loading of shortage, that is 2,000 into 1 by 5. 400, and shortage at cost will be written over here, 2000 minus 400, 1600, correct? Then finally, you will tally your this account, you will get what we call gross profit, then net profit. In the branch account, you have credit sales already. Finally, you will get 10,900 as your what we call closing balance. Question number 2.20, if you will look over, in this question, first of all, your rate of profit on cost will be equal to 1 by 2 and rate of profit on invoice price will be equal to 1 by 3, 50 by 150 because Hills Corporation has two branches. One is at Jaipur, another one is at Lucknow. Goods are invoiced to the branches at cost plus 50%. It is given to you in the question itself. Then question states, branch remits all the cash received to head office and all expenses are met by the head office. These are general features. From the following particular, prepare the necessary account and stock and data system to show the profit earned by Jaipur branch. That means logically you have to prepare accounts related to Jaipur branch, even though the head office is having two branches, but you have to prepare accounting only with respect to what we call Jaipur. So opening stock is given 9,200. Nothing is mentioned. So you will consider it at invoice price. You will consider it at invoice price and you will write in the branch stock account as 9,300. And then you will take the loading in the branch adjustment account. This is your branch adjustment account. In the branch adjustment account, you will write here loading on opening stock. That is 9,300 into 1/3. And that is 3,100. Then we have been given goods sent to branch at cost 34,000. Before that, we have been given debtors. You write simply debtors as opening balance in the debtors account. Now, goods sent to branch 34,000 is given to you, but it is given at cost. So, you write here goods sent to branch 34,000 plus 1/2. I have written 1/3. Write 1/2. See, cost price is 34,000. So, you will have to apply the rate of profit on cost, that is 17,000, and invoice price will be equal to 51,000. Then you will take the loading on goods sent to branch account. You can reflect it in this manner, 51,000 invoice price. Now you can apply rate 1/3, 17,000. Then we have been given in this particular question, sales at branch, cash and credit sales is given to you. So you will simply write, and credit sales you will take to the branch debtors. Cash collected from debtors you will write in the branch account. Goods returned by branch to head office, 1,200. You will write goods sent to branch returns, 1,200 in the branch stock account. Then you will take the loading. Load on goods sent to branch returns, 1,200 into 1/3. That is 400. Then in this question we have been given goods transferred from Lucknow branch to Jaipur branch. Whenever there will be a case of goods transferred, always pay attention to the facts that whether you are transferring or whether you are receiving the goods. Because you are Jaipur branch and Lucknow branch has transferred goods to you, that means you have received the goods. So that is why goods transferred will be written towards the debit side of the branch stock account. Is it clear to you or not? Then you will take the loading of this item, load on goods transferred, 1,500 into 1/3, and you will write here 500. Is it clear to you? So then we have got in this case discount allowed to customer, which you will write once in the debtors account and then on the debit side of P&L. Expenses, of course, towards the debit side of P&L. You will tally this account and you will get the balancing figure as 450. This is your what we call shortage, spoilage, whatever you may call it, and you will take the loading. Then you will write here 450 into 1/3. This will be your loading, 150. Closing stock will be your balancing figure. Shortage is given in the question itself. Shortage at branch is given in the question, in fact. So, and once you will write the loading of the shortage, don't forget to write shortage at cost 300 in the P&L account. Now you will balance this account, and when you are going to balance this, your balancing figure will appear towards the credit side, and I need not require to tell you that this should be treated as closing stock. So this balancing figure will be your closing stock, because first preference is given to closing stock. Closing stock is not available, so you will consider it as closing stock. So closing stock, then you will take the loading of closing stock, 4140 into 1/3, that is equal to 1380. Then you will close this account and you will get gross profit. And then finally from branch P&L account, this amount you have transferred here. From here you have subtracted your branch expenses account, discount account, shortage, and this will be your balancing figure, net profit. And then similarly you can close your branch debtors account to get this one as your balancing figure. 2.21, Finlay India Textile opened a branch. Very important, this time you have opened a branch. There had been no question of opening stock, opening data. Goods are invoiced to the branch at selling price fixed by adding 25% to the cost. Cost price plus margin is equal to your invoice price. Cost price is 100, margin is 25, so your invoice price is 125. So your rate of profit on invoice price will be 25 by 125. On cost price, it will be 25 by 100. Correct? From the following particulars relating to 2021, ascertain the profit or loss made at branch under the stock and data system. So goods sent to branch at invoice price is given. I need not require to tell you where you are going to write this item, goods sent to branch account. In the branch stock account, you are going to write goods sent to branch 1,40,000. You will take the loading of this item now. Loading you are going to write in the branch adjustment account. You will write load on goods sent to branch 1,40,000 into 1/5, that is 28,000. Then next is your cash and credit sales. Cash and credit sales, I need not require to tell you that you are going to write these two items towards the credit side of your branch stock account, cash sales, credit sales. And later on, credit sales will also be put towards the debit side of the branch debtors account. Correct? Then we have in this question, cash receipt from debtors 62,400 in the debtors account towards the credit side. You will simply put it up. Discount allowed to customer in the debtors account and in the P&L account. In the P&L account, you will write discount allowed to customer, and of course when you are preparing your debtors account, you have already written credit sale, cash receipt from debtor, and now discount account. Correct? Now in this question, you have been given goods returned by customer. Goods returned by customer means sales return. Now sales return will find place once in the debtors account, that is against the credit sales, and of course in the branch stock account you will also write sales return, that is against the credit sales. This is sales return given. This is not balancing figure. This is sales return. Correct? Given in the question. In this question, sales return is goods returned by customer 2000, right? Cash remitted to branch for expenses. So rent, salary, sundry expenses you are going to write in the P&L account. See, I have written branch expenses. I have added all these items, salary, rent plus sundry expense. I have directly put here 8,000. You can also do this in the examination. Now, in this question, this line is important. Defective cloth found in the sales. See, actually, this is a textile business, in fact. Finlay India Textile Limited. So defective cloth is related to textiles, so it will be considered as goods. So defective cloth, it indirectly it means you have been given a spoilage. So you will write here spoilage 200. Take the loading of spoilage and you will write here spoilage or shortage, whatever you may like. 200 into 1/5 will be your loading, 40 rupees. And then you will write loading at cost, that is shortage at cost 160. You will also write it in the branch P&L account. Correct? Shortage at cost 200 minus 40. Now, why I'm doing this question is, reason being is that everything is over. Now we will tally this account. Correct? Now we will tally this account. If I will tally this account, 1,42,000 debit side figure is higher, and balancing figure which you are going to get in this particular question will be your 4,140. Now spoilage is given, obviously the balancing figure is arriving towards the credit side, so you are having no other alternative than to treat it as what we call your closing stock. So closing stock is your balancing figure. Once you have taken the balancing figure, don't forget to write it over here in the branch adjustment account, loading on closing stock 1/5, 4,140. What is the closing stock? Let let me check this closing stock figure. 1,42,000 minus 1,20,000 minus 200. Actually, it is 21,800. Please rectify this one. Actually, some misprint. This is 21,800. That is why I was suspecting. 21,800 into 1 by 5, I think it will be equal to 4,360. Divided by 5, yes, it is equal to 4,360. Correct? So this is how you are going to do this one. So 21,800 is your closing stock. You have taken the loading. Loading is 4,360. It's okay. Your gross profit is also okay. 23,600 now. And then you can, of your own, compute your net profit also. Net profit is 13,400. And finally, from the debtors account, you will get balancing figure 4,000. Easy question. Should not be of much botheration to you. 2.2, honestly speaking, self-manageable question, because we have now done lots of questions. So these questions should not be a big botheration for you. 2.2. King's Crown Industries, Mumbai has a branch at Madurai to which goods are invoiced at cost plus 25% rates. You can easily manage in this question. The branch makes sales both for cash and credit. Branch expenses are paid direct from head office, and the branch remits all cash to the head office. From the following details, prepare the necessary ledger accounts in the books of the head office to calculate branch profits as per stock and debtor system. So this question, honestly speaking, you can easily manage. Goods received from head office at invoice price. Even though it is given goods received from head office, it indirectly it means goods sent to branch is given, because no goods in transit is given to you. So you can straight away write in the branch stock account goods sent to branch 60,000. Correct? 60,000. You will take the loading. Loading will be equal to 60,000 into 1 by 5. Your loading will be 60,000 into 1 by 5. That is equal to this much. Correct? And then in this question, you have been given returns to head office, returns, goods sent to branch, returns you have written over here. You will take the loading towards the debit side, 1,200 into 1 by 5, that will be equal to 240. Opening stock of branch 6,000 is given. You will take the loading, 6,000 into 1 by 5, that is equal to 1,200. Then you have been given cash sales, credit sales. Cash sales, credit sales. Credit sales will also be written in the debtors account. Now, opening balance of debtors is given to you, 7,200 in debtors account. Cash collected from debtors will also find place in debtors account. Discount and bad debts first you will write in the debtors, then in the P&L account. Goods returned by debtors, you will write it in the debtors, and you will also write it over here, correct, in the branch stock account. Because so many times I have told you, sales return is always written corresponding to credit sales. Then you have rent, rates and taxes, office expenses, both these items in the P&L account. Now branch stock account is given 12,000. You will take the loading. Loading on closing stock, 12,000 into 1 by 5, 2,400. Correct? Then you will tally this account, and when you will tally this account, your credit side is bigger. That is why you are getting balancing figure to 2,400 surplus. Surplus will be written in the branch adjustment account. Finally, then you will get your gross profit 12,960, and branch P&L account gross profit 12,960. All the expenses, discount, bad debts, and your net profit is 9,560. Then you will prepare your branch debtors account. You will get 9,400. So this is how you will do this question. And honestly speaking, 2.3, you should do it of your own. Correct? You try of your own, otherwise, I'm always there. So I think in this particular session, that is more than enough. So shall meet you in the next one.